What's going on, everybody? It is a bit of a quick video today because today we had some really cool news from the Bleach Twitter page itself, and this could actually be some really good news in regarding the anime itself. So if you're really interested in these short little videos, then please click the like and subscribe as you normally would. I would hope that you do. And let's just jump into it, shall we? So, we may actually have some answers in regards to when we're going to get this anime, when we're going to get Core 2, when are we going to see Bleach back on the screens, and when are we going to be expecting some PVs, and this might actually give you some of those answers. Now, of course, we also want to know, is the anime going to look better than Core 1? Is it going to have those big, massive fight sakugas that animators have been gassing up, or more so Hiramitsu has been gassing up? And are we going to get to see who these new animators are that have joined the team? Of course, it's very possible within episode 1 and 2, because following up from episode 13 from Core 1, we're going to get episode 14 and 15 in about, let's just say, 2 months' time, because some special people who have paid to join a lottery, as well as some club outside members, are going to be experiencing episode 14 and 15 for the first time before anyone else. And if this sounds familiar to you, you are completely right, because they did this before Bleach came back as well, and they did a lottery for that as well. And that is actually very surprising. And again, maybe this is my ignorance, but I don't quite remember many anime series do this. Not to this frequent level anyway. Whether it's going to be the same for Core 3 or Core 4, well, that's another question in and of itself. But I do like this, not only because obviously we get to hear about the episodes early and you know, we get a little bit of tease or a bit of taste of what's to come, but I do think it's especially important because it gives us a good idea on how healthy production may or may not be. Now, of course, yes, we did have an early edition for Core 1, and to say the least, episode 3 and 4 had a bit of damage to them or a bit of problems to them. But for the majority of the arc, it was about 80% pretty much on par and pretty great, to say the least. Now, is it going to be the same for Core 2? Well, we don't know yet, but what we do know is that this is a very good sign that episode 1 and 2 are complete, or if not already, very close to completion. And that's great, because I already know some episodes towards the end, I will say, are already being worked on as we speak. And that's very good, because by the time those ending episodes come to air, that will be in 5 months' time. And let's just say Yamamoto versus Yuha took 6 months to finish, or, you know, make and finish. So this is very good for the production. It seems to be going smoothly. I have not heard any issues on the production side like I did previously on Core 1. Of course, I might be wrong, because I don't obviously know every animator and what their issues are. Of course, we have Hashimoto on Twitter do complaining a little bit about the Bleach anime. However, to his, you know, respect, and I do respect these animators a lot, Hashimoto does have a bit of a track record of complaining about every project that he's on. That's not to take away his talents, it's just something that I just take with a little bit of a grain of salt. Because other than that, I haven't really heard anything bad from any of the animators that I've spoke to or heard from. So it sounds extremely positive on my end of the spectrum anyway. So it's an extremely good thing so far to hear that we're going to be getting episodes 1 and 2, or 14 and 15, earlier than we expected to get it. And again, as I said, I don't really hear this with many anime series doing this. So they must be very confident that they can provide these episodes, or at least give us a good idea on marketing. And which, I gotta say, the marketing on Bleach's side, especially in the Japanese side, because, well, in the English side, it's almost non-existent. It's almost like Viz goes copy and paste. You know, whatever Aniplex posts, we'll just post it on our YouTube channels and Twitter accounts. But hey, that's nor here nor there. Seeing, you know, Bleach's marketing in general for Core 1, having the collaboration with Coca-Cola, which like One Piece did recently with McDonald's, you know, these are big companies and very notable companies as well, and it isn't anything to snuff at. Seeing these marketing things with the lot, even Shilling Club Outside, which again, there's going to be a talk show after these episodes, so to hear some stuff from Kubo and some of the voice actors as well as some of the editors is going to be fantastic, because we might get some news in regards to Club Outside or Kubo in general, and maybe even some little hints about the new fight or little extra things that they did here and there, or what they did different that we can discuss as the anime is about to come on our screen. So I feel like the next 2 months after that presentation, so to say, is going to be extremely insightful and very fun to talk about. I also did mention as well that we might actually have a date on our hands of when we can expect Core 2. Now, of course, I am going from past history, and past history suggested that around about July last year, they did exactly the same thing. They did the lottery for seeing the pre-screening, and that was on, obviously, October 10th. And the pre-screening itself was a month before that. So if we correlate the same kind of thing, because as it stands now, it's on the 25th of June. So if we do a little bit of quick maths and going from last year, well, it seems that we're going to probably get the Bleach Core 2 anime around about July 20th to the 25th. Hey, we might even get it on Ichigo's birthday on July 15th. That would be a really cool coincidence or intentional marketing, but that would be really cool. But I'm shouting for the stars on July 20th or 25th, which actually isn't that far-fetched because Bleach did actually air on a Monday at midnight, and this will be on the 24th of July, which will be on a Monday. So who knows? It's going to be interesting to see what time slot they choose and go for. Of course, during that time, we're going to be getting a lot of PVs within that month as well. We'll probably get one before the pre-screening as well, which is usually going to be one. If you count this one that we've already had for Core 2, the little teaser, we'll probably get one more, and then throughout the month, we're probably going to get a lot of TV spots like we did last time. But yeah, overall, I'm excited. I'm expecting these episodes to give us that 1 hour special of the Bambietta sex scene that we're never, ever, ever going to get. But hey, as long as my prediction that the Quincy man didn't hit, I'll be quite happy, because no one gets to touch Bambietta so casually, because she's a queen and we all must respect it. So probably no hour long sex scene as like the memes were on Twitter. And also, I do think this is probably going to cover towards the end of episode 2. My prediction, probably going to be where Kisuke comes with the hollow bait. So we'll see where that goes. I'm very excited. But overall, just thought I'd update you guys. If you are in Japan, go spend the money, go see that lottery, and go have fun. And overall, I think this is very good news for Bleach, because it seems like, you know, the production is still on track and is still looking quite healthy. So tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. It's coming quicker than you think, guys. So, you know, keep your eye out. There's going to be more update videos, I think, more frequently now. So with that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.